Hi, everyone. Brent Besler, Agronomic Service Rep with Syngenta Crop Protection, and welcome to our Grow More Experience site out here in Shallowater, Texas, bringing the Grow More Experience to you. And today we want to focus in on our corn demonstration plots, and you can see we've got some weeds out here. Can you identify this problem weed? This is one that's real popular out here in West Texas. Very prolific in seed production. Yeah, Palmer amaranth. This is a vining weed that certainly can be a problem in certain parts of West Texas. And if we look at that leaf structure there, that three lobes really give it away. Yeah, ivy leaf morning glory. And certainly we have our annual grasses out here too, and this one is certainly a big problem for us in a lot of our region. Barnyard grass, yeah, you can see that prolific seed production there. So let's dive into our tour and see how we can control these problem weeds. So our first showcase that we really want to feature is this two-pass program with Acuron. And just to size this up, we've got running checks on both sides there. And you can see we have a tremendous amount of both Palmer amaranth and barnyard grass and some ivy leaf morning glory there. This is a quart and a half of Acuron applied pre-emerge and then followed back up with another quart and a half of Acuron with a quart of glyphosate early post. And this really focuses in on that the popularity of that two-pass program and why it is so important. And you can see that we have really done an effective job of reducing our seed bank there, both in the bare ground and in the in crop. And this is around 28 days early post, or after our early post application. And you can see very effective in reducing our weed pressure there. Very few weeds, if any, in both the bare ground and in the in crop. A tremendous job. We did a similar trial back in 2021 where we again looked at the split application of Acuron at that quart and a half and then compared it to some local competitive standards out here. And yeah, our local competitive standards did a pretty decent job early season, but certainly as we get out further into the growing season, we were starting to see both broadleaf and grasses starting to break through there. Whereas when our split program with Acuron at that quart and a half followed by a quart and a half did a tremendous job of keeping our weeds from breaking through. Did an excellent job there. Now, if a grower really is in a field where he certainly doesn't have the weed pressure that we're experiencing in our Grow More Experience site here, this is a very effective program. This is Bicep 2 Magnum at the foundation rate of 1.6 quarts per acre, and then we came back in with 3.75 pints of the Acuron GT. And you can see we did an effective job of taking out both our broadleaf and grasses, both in our bare ground and as we get into our in crop. Again, this is 28 days after our early post and a very effective program. Yeah, we've got a few morning glories starting to break through, but certainly at this stage, not competitive at all and certainly not yield robbing. To me, it's about making sure that you're controlling the weeds before they come up. Again, it's one of those situations that if a weed has already emerged, and most of our growers out here grow thousands and thousands of acres, and so it's all about timing. And if they're waiting or if they're having to cover thousands of acres and they come out, you know, 5 to 6 weeks after they've had their pre-out and they're trying to cover all these acres, more than likely you're going to have weeds up that are going to be 8 to 10 inches tall. So it's about being on a good program, knowing that, okay, I've got my pre down. I know that within 3 to 3.5 weeks, I need to be planning to get out there and put my post applied. Again, it's all about overlapping those residuals and minimizing as much as you possibly can, having weeds emerge that you have to go again and control over the top.